Hi folks, another what? Another food taste test for you today. Something a little bit different. These are Sharon, not Sharon's favourites in the slightest. I don't mind some of them, but they are meat-free burgers. You're not looking forward to this one, are you?
I'm not looking forward to it.
Well, I was a vegetarian for about 9 months a couple of years ago, and I had these ones. These are the Linda McCartney vegetarian mozzarella quarter pounders burgers.
Your favourite, weren't they?
They was my favourite. And I ate them for quite a while, and I did enjoy them, actually. But these other ones I've not actually tasted. We've also got the vegan no-bull steak burgers. This amazes me. Why do you call it a steak burger?
It needles me.
Especially being vegan and all, because they don't like anything to do with meat, do they?
Yeah.
And where did we get this from?
Iceland Warehouse.
Iceland Warehouse. These also come from Iceland Warehouse, but we used to get these from Lidl, and they still sell them in Lidl.
You can get them in every supermarket.
Yeah, and they do them on offer quite often. How much are these ones for the two?
They were £2.50.
£2.50 for the Linda McCartney ones. How much for the no-bull steak burgers?
£2.
£2. And the third one, these come from?
Sainsbury's.
Sainsbury's. These are, what are they called?
Future Burgers.
Future Burgers. The revolutionary burger made from plants with texture and tastes like meat.
Oh, I bet it doesn't.
That's quite a big promise, that one. How much that one cost, baby?
£2.90. It was on offer as
£2.90. And they're basically plant based.
Open it up
and
look at it.
Well, we'll start at the beginning, baby. So let's open the boxes and we'll put the nutritional information on the page so you can see what's in them. And we'll go first of all for the Linda McCartney burger. Let me go and open that one up for, or let Sharon open that one up for us. I said all that in one breath.
Didn't you?
Wait. So there's the box, folks. That's the Linda McCartney burger. It contains two burgers. You normally cook these from frozen, do you?
I do, yeah.
Because when they defrost, they're a little bit hard to handle, so to speak. They don't resemble meat in any way. They've got little white bits in. I don't quite know
what
they are.
That's the mozzarella.
Oh, of course it is. Yeah, that's the mozzarella. I didn't realise that. Well done, baby. So that's the Linda McCartney burgers. As I say, we're only going to take one out for the moment. The next one is the vegan no-bull steak burgers.
No, folks, you can't get into them.
Two steak-style burgers.
Are you ready, people?
Let's have a look at these.
Oh, my God.
Well, you can see there's a lot of currying on that one. It's also a lot thicker. Are these all supposed to be quarter pounders? I don't really know.
No, they're just burgers, aren't they?
Yeah. 227 grams in the Linda McCartney's. 226 in the no-bull steak burgers. And the Future Burger... I don't know whether this is vegan or not. I don't think it says on the packet.
Oh my God, would you look at that?
They come with a lot more packaging, folks. As you can see, you've now got to get rid of this plastic type packaging as well. So let's open that up.
Oh, get a knife.
Yeah. Again, you need to cut this, folks. Normally there's a little simple way you can get into them, but they don't appear to have it on this.
Oh no.
They look a bit soggy, don't they?
These are in the fridge. These weren't frozen.
These weren't frozen. There you go, folks. That's that one. And they all sort of got this mushy sort of texture. So there you go, folks. All meat-free. The middle one claims to be vegan. I don't think the other two do. But we're going to cook them in our air fryer, our Ninja. So let's get them on, shall? Get them cooked up. We'll put them in a bun and we'll give them a taste test and we'll see how we go. Right, so this is our Ninja air fryer, folks. We've cooked basically everything in here now because, everything we can cook in there. We'll just lay them in there. We know what they look like, so we'll put in two in one and then we'll put one in the other compartment because we've got a dual compartment in this one. And the one on its own is the meat-free one, isn't it? The Future Burger. There's the Future, yeah. The Future Burger is in on its own. So, right, so we're going to put it on for 200 for 10 minutes, but we'll just check halfway through anyway. And there we go, both on for 10 minutes. We'll see how they go. And
we'll get the buns ready, shall we? That happens.
Yep. Right, so we've just bought some sesame seed and what's that, poppy seed?
Four sesame topped milk burger buns.
Again, we will taste the corner of these on their own, but hopefully when we put all the other ingredients in, it should improve the taste.
We'll I prepared this earlier to go in the burgers
right,
as well.
Right, so what we got there? We've got some lettuce, we've got some cucumber and onion. Some onion. And we'll put some cheese in there as well. How about that? Because at the end of the day, I've got a feeling that you're not going to like these. And I'm trying to improve the flavour of it for you to see if they are tolerable or palatable for you. 4 minutes in, folks. So let's have a little look at them. Yeah, I think we can turn them over, baby. Do you want to turn them over? Ready to turn over easy enough?
Yeah.
There we go. That's the future burger.
Oh, it's stacked. Oh, that's nice.
There we go. They cook really good in here, folks. So we've got another five and a half minutes now. Right, okay then. So we're back now. We're with under a minute to go. Sharon's prepared all the buns. We've laid everything out now. Let's have a look at them. It says a minute to go there, but I think we've just had a little peek on them and they actually look like they're ready. There's them two there. And there's the future burger in there. I think they're already done, so let's turn it off. So as you can see, they're sizzling away in there, folks. They haven't shrunk at all, not like a meat burger does. So I'm gonna get these out now. We'll put them on the table and then we'll come back to you. Right, folks, here they are in their orders. So this one on this side is the Linda McCartney burger. The one in the middle is the no ball steak burger. And the one on the right-hand side is the future burger. And one thing that concerns me, I don't quite like the sound of that. On the packet there, it says non-GMO, no gluten, and no antibiotics. I don't know what that means, folks, but that don't sound very appealing to have on a food packet, but there you go. Right, Sharon. Let's cut a little corner off of each. Start with a mozzarella burger. You want to cut it down, that's it down there, and then cut that in half so I can have a bit as well. Right, so that's that one. Cut that in half. And let's have a little go. So this one is the Linda McCartney burger. Go on in you go. They're very chewy. They look like a burger, but they don't obviously taste like a burger.
I don't know what they taste of.
There's no stating what they do taste like, but as you say, not like a burger. There is a hint of mozzarella. You get them in little sort of chunks. They sort of melt.
I didn't get no mozzarella.
They sort of melt and then they go solidify again, and you can taste them as little chunks in there. So that's the one. Well, that's okay. I don't mind that. I've eaten them for a 9 month period, so I'm happy with them. This one I haven't tried before. This is a no ball steak burger. The consistency is a lot thicker with this one. Let's have a little go with it.
I'll tell you what, it's a shame you can't smell it.
Yeah, it's a funny old... It's more of a herby smell to that, isn't it?
Oh, my God.
Texture-wise, all I'm getting...
Nothing, no taste, there's no flavour.
It's a crust around and the mushy bit in the middle.
It says wheat, protein and mushroom steak style burger.
And the Sharon says there's no actual flavour to it. So if you're putting it in a burger, whatever you surround the burger and what sauces you put on.
Mum, you'd have to get some chilli sauce.
And it's quite thick there. I don't know if you can see inside that, folks, but it's thick but soft. Crusty on the outside, but very soft and mushy.
Oh, there's an aftertaste coming through now.
On the inside. Now, this is the one I was really interested in. This is the future burger.
This is your future.
Yeah, let's have a little go at this one. Yeah, there is an aftertaste with a pair of them, to be honest with you. It's not a very nice aftertaste.
It's a soapy aftertaste.
Yeah, it is a bit soapy, actually. There's no smell with it.
Oh, hang on, I can smell soap.
No, I can't smell anything. Rubbery. When you swallow it...
Don't say nothing if it's horrible.
You do get a bit of an aftertaste. But texture-wise...
That's about the best.
That's about the nearest to meat. Even more so than this first one, which I've been eating for quite a while now.
Mm.
But there is no disguising. It isn't meat, is it?
No.
And there's not much flavour, but the texture of it is nearly meat-based. Right, so let's build these up in burgers now, baby, to see if we can get some more flavour into them. Right, I'm going to get some mayonnaise, hold on. I know I like the old, where's it? Sriracha sauce, Sharon.
What should be all in there?
Right, let's get that. We get the sriracha sauce out, folks. Look, because if you're a vegetarian for whatever reason and you're not eating red meat, you want to make something taste a bit better.
Perhaps they've lost their taste buds for being a vegetarian.
All right, let's put a little bit of mayonnaise on each of them.
Only a small bit.
Yeah, I know. That's all. That's all, baby. We're gonna put cheese. You should put cheese on first, Sharon.
See, cheese is on the top on that one.
Well, I don't know.
There you go. There's no right or wrong.
There's
way.
No right or wrong, is there?
How you want it at the end
so
of
we'll
the day.
So we'll just formulate these. So yeah, that definitely looks the more meatier of the three, even though there's no meat in it. But yeah, we'll just make these up, folks, and we'll see if we can improve the flavour a little bit. They look like burgers, don't they? They look like a burger.
They should do, they're expensive enough.
Yeah, and that's the thing, that's what you've got to remember as well, folks, yeah. They're normally dearer, a lot dearer than normal burgers. So value for money wise, you're not getting much flavour in our opinion for...
You're getting no flavour.
Well, you're not getting no flavour, that's what I'm saying. You're having to add your flavour in the way of sauces, for example. Right, okay, so whack a bit of that sriracha on the top. I like to taste it, baby.
Yeah, don't forget I'm having a bite.
I know.
Christ.
I do tend to whack that on, folks, that sriracha. So there you go. As you can see now, they look a whole lot more appetising when you add something to them. So fold them over. Right, okay, future burger first, folks. Just push that down a bit and cut that in half. Right, baby. Have a go at that future burger. Here we go.
It looks nice like that.
Looks all right like that, folks. Look.
You still tell it's not meat.
That's not bad. Really, it's not bad, is it? Forget it's not meat. You're a vegetarian, you can't eat meat. For a burger, with all the stuff on, it's not bad. It's like when you eat soy. Oh, what's them little cubes?
Corn. That's horrible.
On its own, it's horrible. When you add stuff to it, it makes all the difference. And that, I could eat that as a burger at a barbecue, I tell you. That's that one. This is the No Ball Steak Burger. This one is thicker than the others. And it's retained that thickness as well. So let's have a little go at this. Yeah, look, that's that one. Not, don't look as appetising, to be honest with you. No, I don't like that one. No. That one. I don't want to go in for a second bite on that one. No, I don't like that at all. So that one is definitely a no-no from me. And what about you?
No, they're all
nose
at the moment.
Well, final one. Now these ones are the ones I've been used to, as I said to you, the Linda McCartney Burgers. So I'm expecting to like this one. And there you go, folks. They do look like a burger, as you can see there. Look.
Just don't taste like one.
Well, not on its own, but we've added stuff to it now, baby.
Right. Ruining my salad.
Yeah, I'll eat that. As I have done.
And I'll eat that.
I'm going for a second bite, folks. Because I'm not sure which one of them is my favourite.
That's the best one
I'll go back to the future burger.
My God, give me a proper meat burger. I'm sorry to you vegetarians out there and vegans, but I'm a meat eater. And this is definitely confirmed, I'm a meat eater.
My favourite is the future burger. And that surprises me. That was the least appealing one looking.
Yeah.
That I didn't think I would enjoy. Don't enjoy them on their own.
No.
But in a bun texture. With all your stuff on it, just like when you're eating corn, it's the flavours you add to it. And that's all I'll suggest. Apart from this one in the middle, which is the No Ball Steak Burger, that I don't want to take another bite of that. Just our opinion, folks. It's just our opinion.
My opinion is I will never be buying.
She's not a vegetarian. She's never been vegetarian. I was vegetarian for 9 months, so I ate a lot of vegetarian food.
Couldn't do it.
And out of them, I was living off of them to a certain extent. Near enough every night, wasn't I, Sharon? But out of them, I'd say the Future Burger was my favourite.
It's the Future.
I'm still eating meat, though.
I'm not giving up meat for nothing. Anyway. Sorry, brother.
What's brother?
He's always on about me.
Her brother's vegetarian.
No, I've tried it. I've done it here. And that's definite no.
Anyway, thank you very much, folks. Just our opinion, as I've said to you many, many times. We will do put out 3 videos a week. We go on a Monday, a Wednesday and Friday. We can review any different types of food. It doesn't really matter. As I say, Sharon didn't really want to do this one, but she bucked up and done it.
And I'll be giving the rest to my dogs.
And anyway, we'll see you in the next video, folks. We'll see you on Sunday as well, because we put out a family vlog on Sunday.
After a Sunday roast.
When you can see what we get up to normally during the week. Anyway, thanks very much, folks. I'll see you in the next video. And until then, bye for now.
Bye-bye.